Hey guys, I'm Dr. Pavitra, and today let us see how we can prepare for the upcoming theory exams in pediatrics. If you like the content of my channel, please subscribe and share among your academic and student groups so that we will all learn pediatrics together and we will see how to prepare for this theory exam. I'll jump into the topic without any further ado. Okay, first you need to know the content that you need to prepare. So make a list of all the systems that are present in your textbook, whichever textbook you are following, it does not matter. Okay, just broad topics. You need not write the breakdown of topics like say cardiovascular system, respiratory system, CNS, those will do. Don't forget to add these extra random tidbits like social pediatrics, biostatistics. Those are topics where questions come regularly, but they are not present in your textbooks. Don't forget to add critical care pediatrics and neonatology, because usually we tend to read them from a different book than the standard books. And also add your journal reading like IJPP, IEP, and reading for recent advances paper, which we have discussed in our previous lecture. I had given you a few areas from which you can read from. So those also include in your list. So I will just give you an example of how the list might look like. So this is a list that I have made. These are common pediatric topics like core pediatrics, basically nutrition, vaccination, behavioral pediatrics, learning disorders. Then you have general topics like your social pediatrics, drugs, medications, procedures, and unclassified. I did not know what else to put in that. Miscellaneous are very, very small pediatric topics like ENT and ophthal. Then you have small systems, proper systemic pediatrics like allergy, rheumatology, genetics. They are all systemic, but they don't take much of your time to prepare, and it is not given much importance also by us. Then you have your large systemic disorders and your critical care pediatrics. Critical care, don't forget to include this poisoning that we tend to usually forget. We will read everything else, but unfortunately poisoning gets left out. This environmental hazard like your drowning, electrocution, and your fluoride intoxication, those get left out. Okay, so if you can make a list of all this, you will have a broad idea as to what and all you will need to cover. Apart from this, you need to add your journal reading, and if at all you are listening to lectures, those IAP guidelines, etc. Then mark down your weak areas. For me, the weak areas are perennially these topics. How much ever times I read, every time I try to open the topic, I feel slightly threatened. Okay. Now, are you ready to plan? Yeah, to some extent. But before that, you need to know a few more things. You need to know the quantity in each system. Okay. So it can be either by page numbers or it can be by questions. I would prefer if it by questions, because you know which systems are given much importance to in your preparations. So mark down previously asked questions and mark down questions that possibly could be asked. Always trust your gut feelings, guys. That is what I will tell. If you feel some question might be asked and if you feel it is important, give importance to it. You don't have to sit and go through each and every question paper to put down your questions. There are ready-made sites which are available, which is like dnbpediatrics.com. This is completely unsponsored. I'm giving you a disclaimer. This site has helped me a lot while preparing, and hence I'm sharing it with you guys. And know what type of reader are you. See, suppose you are someone who can crunch down on a single system for 2 to 3 days together, then well and good, good for you. But suppose if you are someone who's like me, who has got a very short attention span, I do this flit and fleeting thing like rheumatic fever. Okay, I cannot sit with one system continuously for more than 2 to 3 hours. So what I do is I read multiple systems per day. So whatever works for you, stick to it. And decide if you are going to read pages wise or question wise. Say, suppose you are taking cardiovascular system to read, and say there are 300 pages in whichever book you have chosen. So you can either say per hour, I am going to finish 20 pages. And so total cardiovascular system, I will finish in these many hours. So that can be your way of doing. Or you can say there are 60 to 70 questions in cardiovascular systems that can be potentially asked. So I will read, say, 5 questions in an hour. So that can also be done. But it depends on you. If something is working for you, stick to it. What works for me may not work for you. Okay, so what I'm trying to do in this is just give a general outline or general direction in which you guys can go. But if this is not working for you, I completely understand and I respect your point of views. So which is preferred among these? See, you can do pages wise or question wise, but having said that, try to formulate questions is what I will tell. Because if you are reading passively, say if you are reading questions wise or pages wise, it can be either. But if you are doing a passive reading of say so many pages or so many questions, that is not going to retain in the long term for you. Ask a question and try to answer first. Okay, so if, whichever way you are reading, try to ask a question. Suppose the question is on say, what shall we take? Nephrotic syndrome. Let us take nephrotic syndrome. All right. So suppose a question is asked on nephrotic syndrome. Just think to yourself, what are the topics that you would like to cover in nephrotic syndrome? You would like to see what is the definition or criteria for nephrotic syndrome, types of nephrotic syndrome, age distribution, sex distribution. And then you would like to think about the pathogenesis. What are the clinical manifestations and why are those clinical manifestations happening? If you can answer all these questions, these are all questions that are put forth by yourself to yourself. Okay. If you are able to answer all these questions, then you are good. You know your subject, you'll be able to answer the question in your exams, whichever way it is asked. In case you are not able to answer, you will know this is where you are lacking. So you can concentrate on those areas. So what I would suggest is, this is just a suggestion, formulate your own questions and try to answer those questions. Where to read from? There are multiple standard textbooks. Okay, there are multiple standard textbooks. There are multiple preparation textbooks. It can be your notes. Does not matter. Stick to what you have already read. Say, suppose you are someone who's extremely brilliant and you have read only from Nelson. Stick to Nelson. Okay. The people who say reading from Nelson cannot be reproduced in paper, let them go wherever they want to go. You have read from Nelson. You're confident you can answer from Nelson. And when you're recalling, you're able to do it, then stick to Nelson. Okay. Suppose you're somebody who has been reading IAP textbook of pediatrics or OP guy or PG textbook of pediatrics. Stick to it. Whatever you are reading, stick to it and make sure you know everything that is given in that book. Okay. Don't see your neighbor reading some other textbook and get tempted to read that book. Okay. If they say it is good, say, all right, it is good, but I will finish my book. Stick to what you're reading. I cannot emphasize this enough. Last minute reading from a new book is not going to help you. Okay. Because your mind is wired to whatever you have been reading so far. Introducing something new will not be retained that well. All right. Whenever, if you can just imagine what you had been doing in your MBBS exams, you will remember that when a question is asked, your mind automatically switches to the page or paper from which you had read that. Correct. It could have been your notes or it could have been a textbook. But your mind will immediately jump to that page. Your mind's picture will be seeing, this was there in the right hand side top corner. Some diagram was there, no? Isn't it so? That is how your brain works. So try to stick to what you have read already. All right. This is very, very important. Suppose there's a topic about which you have no idea. It is completely new, or this is a topic that you have been ignoring so far. Everybody is guilty of that. Don't feel bad, including me. Okay. There are some topics I will put it down in my notes or I will put it down in my plan to study it at some point in time. But whenever that day comes, I will try to occupy myself with something else so that I don't have to read it. Okay. Some of the topics are like autism spectrum and ADHD. I have been trying to read it for so long. I cannot tell you guys, but I could never bring myself to read it. But when an exam comes, there's no other go. You have to read it because at least one or the other is asked every year. Okay. It could be either autism spectrum or ADHD. Something or the other is asked every year. So you should know both these topics. So in that case, what do? If you are good with reading textbooks, if you feel you are not going to fall asleep reading a textbook on these topics, start with a book that is basic. Okay. Don't start with a book that has got a extremely good English. We doctors are not basically good English readers, guys. Okay. We tend to fall asleep. So start with a book that has got a basic English, basic explanation. Or if you feel you're going to fall asleep in the first paragraph, try to listen to a lecture or video that is engaging. Okay. If you think you cannot do that, ask someone who knows to teach you in a simple way to write an answer. Okay. It should not be too lengthy that you fall asleep when someone teaches you to. It should be crisp and short so that you can retain the contents. And in case you want to read from a book, you can draw from what they have taught you and apply it to what you're reading in the textbook. You get my point? And what about allotment of time? See, now you have the systems, you know how you are going to read it, and you know the content of each systems. Okay. How are you going to allot your time? You should know how much time you can spend per day. Each person is different. Again, see, I may be someone who's sitting at home and preparing for DNB theory exams. There may be another person who's working in hospitals and can spend only, say, 4 to 5 hours per day. There may be someone who's sitting for the whole day preparing only for this. So it does not matter. The quantity of time that you spend does not matter. The quality matters. Okay. Each day, again, is not the same, especially for us who go to work. Isn't it so? So one day you may be having a very busy duty and you will feel tired and you will not be able to spend more than 2 to 3 hours. But the next day you will feel completely energized and you can spend even 7 hours per day on reading. It does not matter. Know the minimum amount and the maximum amount of time that you can spend on an average, okay, per day. And you can have a idea about what to do with extra time. That extra time might be spent on topics that you are weaker in. Or that extra time might be spent on topics that are given or asked for recent advances paper. Or it can be used for reading questions that you have been ignoring or that you could not read the previous day or the day before. So what I would suggest is your weakest topics that you put down initially, break it down into small chunks. Sorry if you're hearing a bell ringing. We are doing puja at our home. I'm sorry if it is disrupting you guys. I hope I'm clear through the audio. Okay. So split the weakest topics into small chunks and split the newest topics into small chunks. Okay. What you can do is spend some amount of time each day for those topics rather than reading it all together. Suppose if I am forced to read a topic on behavioral pediatrics and learning disorders in one full day, I will fall asleep in the first 1 to 2 hours and I will be discouraged for the whole entire day and I will not be able to read anything else. So what I would suggest that you do is you can split it into small chunks and spread it over the next few days. Suppose this behavioral pediatrics is somewhere you feel you are weak. What you can do is split it and read it over the next 5 days so that you don't feel overwhelmed. At the same time, you have a small sense of achievement that you have completed it. Okay. You can do it pages wise or question wise, again, whichever you want, but formulate your own questions and try to answer them. For example, if I want to read for the next week, cardiovascular system, I want to complete. So what I will do is I will divide cardiovascular system however I see fit. And then apart from cardiovascular system, I will try to read 1 to 2 questions which are new topics or something that can be asked in recent advances and 1 to 2 questions that I am actually weak in. Sorry for the spelling mistake. It can be, assumed as both W-E-E-K week and W-E-A-K week. Either is fine. All right. So you get my point. So divide as you see fit. This is just a suggestion. This is what I am doing right now. So I thought I would share it with you guys. So you have formulated a plan. You know, for each system, you're going to allot, say, these many hours or these many days. And you know that these are the contents that you need to concentrate on. Plan for very short spans of time. Okay. Try not to plan for the whole 2 months, whole 3 months. That is physically not possible. One, and two, you will not be able to judge what is going to happen in the future. Okay. So you may be able to spend 5 hours now, but maybe next week you'll be able to spend only 3 to 4 hours. And the week after that, maybe 6 to 7 hours. So don't do a long span of time. Okay. See that if you'll be able to finish it in 2 months, because you would have already set your time for each system. If you're able to do that, then plan, micro plan for next 5 to 10 days alone. Don't stretch yourself out. Okay. If you can do it in small successes, you will feel accomplished and you will feel more motivated to complete in the next coming days. Okay. This is a model for a mixed bag reader who will not be able to sit with a single system. For me, I am able to read only 4 to 5 hours a day and I am not able to spend more than that. This is a real plan that I am following right now. This is not a plan to just share with you guys. This is what I am doing actually. So nephrology, I'm planning to read six questions per day, spending about 1.5 hours, and urology around 2 questions per day. Behavioral pediatrics, 3 questions per day. I'm going to spend 1 hour, and environmental hazards about 1 question per day, just 30 minutes. IAP guidelines, just 1 guideline from the site, 30 minutes. And IJPP, just 1 article per day. I have started reading the April, June COVID-19 edition. Just 30 minutes per day. It's going to be just single article and single guideline. So I don't think I'll be needing more than that. And always allot an extra 30 minutes for revision. Okay. Revision is very, very important. Whatever you have read the previous day, try to recall the next day and see if you're able to do it completely. If you feel you're forgetting something, immediately refer and again recall, so that you will retain the information for a long time. You can do this revision by yourself or you can do it in groups. Either can be done. Whichever works for you, stick to it. Don't jump into a group if you are already doing well alone. And don't try to study alone if you are doing well in groups. Try to stick to what you are already doing. And try to not put the revision at the end of the day. Try to do it as soon as you get up. Because by the end of the day, you are tired, you are exhausted from your work, from your studying and all that. And you will not have the mindset to actually sit and revise what you have read already. Okay. So try to get up in the morning and the first thing you do, start revising. You can just do a mental rundown of what you were reading the previous day and you can continuously try to, you know, think about what you have read. It need not be a sit and think. It can be like you're walking, you're brushing, you're drinking your milk. You can have a mental rundown of what you have already read. Try not to be conjuice and reduce this time for revision, because revision is what will help you in your exams. I cannot stress this enough, guys. This is not a waste of time. Revising is not a waste of time. The later you go closer towards your exam, the lesser time you will need for revising this topic again and again. Because the first time you read a question, you might take, say, 45 minutes to an hour. But the next time you revise, it might be just 30 minutes. And the time after that, it will be just 15 minutes. And just before exams, if you're going to run through, you will have just 5 to 6 minutes per question for you to revise. Isn't it so? So for you to reach that 5 to 6 minutes per question for a difficult question, you need to have revised this multiple times. Always do it in a question answer format. Again and again, I'm telling you. Only then you will know whether you actually know it or you think you know it. Practice writing. Because whatever question paper it may be, it contains anywhere from 10 to 20 questions per paper, depending upon whichever university you're attending. And each paper lasts for 180 minutes, 3 hours exam, correct? So per question, you will have 9 to 18 minutes. If it is 10 questions per paper, it will be 9 minutes. And if it is 20, it is 18. If it is 10 questions, 18 minutes and 20 questions, 9 minutes. You guys get the idea, right? So you need to be able to write something in 10 minutes so that the examiner deems it fit to give at least 4 out of 5 or at least 3 out of 5, if not 4. So for that, you need to know some content. And you don't want to get tired at the end of the day. And you don't want your hand paining so that you're not able to do properly in your next exams. The first exam you might do well, but at the end of the day, your hand will be so cramped up. The next day, you will find it difficult to even hold a pen properly. So try to write something daily. It can be anything. You need not, you know, sit and write the whole answer. I'm not asking you to do that. Okay. You can say for revision part, you can try to quickly write down few sentences. Or you want to actually take notes of something that you are forgetting? Yeah, do that. But continuously write. Okay? Because it's been a long time that all of us have sat for a theory exam proper. We would have written case sheets. We would have written notes and all that. But those are all not time constrained. But this is a time constrained thing. So try to time yourself and write a question or answer for say 10 minutes so that you know you are able to complete it and you are not overwhelmed when you are writing an exam, because we don't want to miss any questions that you can actually answer to. Correct? How to study in allotted time? So suppose say you have allotted 3 hours for cardiovascular system today or nephrology today. Finish off the questions that you know already, because you would have planned that you will be reading these 10 questions today for 3 hours. Among these 10 questions, you know 4 questions already. You know that for sure you have been treating those patients or you have read it already. Finish off revising those. So for 3 hours, from the 3 hours, you would have finished these 4 questions in the first half an hour to 40 minutes. So you are left with 2.5 hours for just 6 questions. You will feel very, you know, happy that you have more time. So you can spend more time on weaker areas for that particular day. And always give importance to repeated questions. Try not to avoid them. Okay. Try not to say read questions that are obscure, that have not been asked so far first, and read questions that you know already or that have been asked later. Give importance to important questions. Don't give importance to unimportant questions is what I would tell. What not to do? Don't change your style of reading, looking at somebody. Okay. What has worked for you will work for you, will continue to work for you, will keep on continuing to work for you. Okay. So don't change how you have been reading. Don't change your books. Okay. Whatever you have been reading will help you throughout. Be confident of that. Okay. Have faith in yourself. Don't allow digital distractions. The moment you take your phone, that is 30 minutes lost. 100%. You will just try to open your phone to look at a WhatsApp or a Telegram message and you will get sucked into it. Okay. Don't allow for digital distractions. Don't procrastinate. Okay. If you are not able to do, just write it down on the side. Try not to push what you have to next day. If you are able to finish it today, complete it today. Don't postpone it. Okay. Suppose there are overlapping questions. Overlapping questions is like some questions can be asked in fluids and electrolytes and some questions can be asked in nephrology also. For example, your metabolic acidosis, your hyponatremia, hypernatremia. Suppose you have prepared a set of questions for nephrology and it has these metabolic acidosis, hyponatremia. And sometimes when you are not in mood, even I am also guilty of doing this. What I will think is, I will read it when I am reading fluid and electrolytes and not in nephrology. And when I try to read fluids and electrolytes, what I will tell? I will read it in nephrology. So when you keep bouncing this question from either topics, you end up not reading it at all. So if you have something in your set of questions, read it off today. Doesn't matter if it gets repeated again. You can read it again. Isn't it so? That becomes a revision for you. So don't push overlap questions to another time or day that is set for another topic. And don't be overwhelmed by the amount of content that you have to prepare. That is why I'm asking you to plan for just a short few days and not too much. Okay. If you plan for too much, you get overwhelmed by the amount of content that you need to do. Don't worry. See, all of these questions are patients that you might have seen at some point in time or another. This is not something new. This is something that you have been training for the past 2 to 3 years, isn't it? So you're not opening your book for the first time. You know these things. So don't be overwhelmed. You will be able to answer these questions. And last but not least, don't Xerox somebody else's notes. Those notes are only for that person, because that person has prepared it in a way that they will be able to understand. Okay. Unless you are very, very desperate, Xerox notes, but I am not sure how much it is going to help you, because it has not helped me. Only my notes has helped me and not somebody else. Okay. If somebody else is lending you notes, ask them to teach from the notes first, so that you have an idea of how it is prepared and how it is arranged in it, so that you can read better. What can you do is, you know the content that needs preparation. Unless you know the content, you will not be able to allot time. Saying randomly, I will spend 8 hours for cardiovascular system and 10 hours for respiratory system will not work. When you actually put down the questions or the content that needs to be prepared, you will actually be surprised to see that you will not be able to complete in the time that you thought was possible. So know the content, then allot your time. Know your areas of strength and weakness so that you can spend more time on your weaker parts and you can strengthen your parts which are already strong by revising it. Because what you know, you are going to revise. You are not going to read it again. Correct? And plan in short spans. With this we have discussed. And you have planned your work. Try to work your plan, but be flexible. Okay? What you can do is the previous day night, write down what needs to be studied for the next day. Say in a sticky notes or in a paper and stick it somewhere that you see as soon as you get up. So your mind will continuously start working on what things needs to be done for today. Okay? But be flexible. Say suppose you plan to read some on CVS, some on NEFRO, some on environmental hazard, some on IAP, etc., etc. And you have already marked down time. Say 6:30 to 7:30 a.m. I want to finish this. 7:30 to 8:30 I want to finish this. That's well and good. But suppose say morning you're getting up and you're not in the mood to read the topic for 6:30 to 7:30. Say for example. You don't want to read environmental hazards the first thing in morning. What to do? Read something else that have been allotted for that day. Okay. So you can stick to your plan, but be flexible also. Always give heed to your mood. Suppose you are not feeling up to it. Don't push yourself. Try to read something else. And every day is new. Suppose you are not able to complete something the previous day. Don't feel guilty over it. Treat every day as new and start reading from start. Okay. And revise, revise, revise. This is very, very important. And practice writing. Suppose you are not in a mood. This happens to all of us. Correct? You don't feel like getting up in the morning, or if you get up, you feel like very lazy, or you feel as if your brain is made of cotton wool and nothing is going through your brain. Correct? All of us have gone through this phase. All of us have gone through these downs and ups. Correct? So if that is the case, what I can suggest you is, what can help is change the location of where you're studying. Suppose you are used to reading in your room. Try to take your books, notes, or your laptop or tablet, whichever you are reading from, and change the location. Sometimes that helps. Change mode of studying. Say you are continuously reading from books and you feel like you're going to fall off, nod off. Listen to your lecture. Relax for a while. Okay. By relax, I don't mean looking at Netflix or Prime Video. No, that is not relaxing. Okay. Again, you're straining your eyes. Close for your eyes, take a power nap or go for a walk, listen to music, something like that. Okay, don't ever indulge in digital distraction because that is not going to stop at just 15-minute break. It will continue till, say, the episode is over. Okay, so don't do that. And don't get into this spiral. Just because you have not completed a topic, you will feel upset. And just because you are upset, you will try to distract yourself by looking at some phones or tablets. And because of that, you feel you have again wasted your time and you will feel guilt and you will feel upset. So this becomes this continuous spiral of guilt and upset, and ultimately you end up not reading anything. Okay. Suppose you are not able to complete, doesn't matter. Leave the topic then and there. Go to the next topic that is in hand. Okay. Every day is new. Note down in a separate paper that the topic you have missed. And those topics can be covered whenever you get some extra time. Okay, or you can ask someone to teach you. It does not matter if you are not able to cover everything. It does not matter, because if you are able to cover everything else, you will be able to draw from those and you will be able to answer this question if at all it is asked. Because everything in medicine is interconnected. All the best for your exam, guys. If you have any more doubts, feel free to contact me. Feel free to comment. I will try to reply you guys as soon as possible. Okay. So you need not be motivated all the time. That is not possible. But try to be disciplined, and that will take you a long way. Best wishes for your exams.